Nobody's here. Not even a bot. Wow. There's not even any bots. It's pretty impressive. Do we have a safe working environment? Almost. So yeah, take a quick gander, mate. You should see the detail on this chaplain now. He looks like a badass. I gotta make his gun holders the wrong, is too bright. I tried to make it gold. It doesn't really work. It needs to be like a dark
back
black.
To showing you past broadcasts again.
Hey, it's cool.
Oh, click play, it'll be your old one. Right, I see it now.
I'm just trying to get the focus command up. And autofocus off. There we go. It's just a little bit sharper. Yeah. Check this shit. Look at this guy.
Look at
that. It's awesome.
Yeah, you painted it, Tom.
Yeah, it's better, mate. Let me just try to fucking. Oof. There you go, open that hatch up. Yeah. Look at that skull with the Aquila. Well, it's more like an iron cross.
Where's the orc? Needs an orc inside it.
We've got the. I'm going to put a bit of copper.
An orc.
I'm going to put copper around the bottom of these. So that's the dread. I'm going to take a look at this guy up close. Look at that. Oh yeah, I had an idea as well, dude, yeah? Hang on, let's see if I can do this. So he's about here. You could just be like, you just put on a silly voice and be like, "Welcome!" You see? First thing you must learn about heresy is you're a heretic.
It says right here, you're a heretic.
All you have to do is just kind of move him a bit as he's talking. Yes, that's right. Brexit in name only. Yeah, I've been having a little bit of fun. Like, this guy looks really dope. He's probably the most detailed guy I've ever painted.
Hello.
But yeah, have fun, mate. I'm just gonna be touching up these guys.
In a bit.
All right. Bardo Bedado. Slow, cool, and Commander Root, welcome to the stream. Nearly finished the commander.
Food!
Food. Food. What?
Are you eating bread?
Do you like painting things?
No, I detest it.
Oh.
It's really boring. And it gets everywhere. It's like a full-time job. You gotta get money for it.
You can't get money for it, mate.
It's good for learning patience as well.
That's right, that is.
Which is something you need a lot of developing video games.
Yep. Mate, as soon as I look at code, I'm just like, I can't be
asked.
Oh,
it's not the code. It's not the code. It's the testing group I worry about. That's what's stressing
me. No, I'm just saying personally for me, if I look at lines of code, I'm like, well, I understand it, but I really can't be bothered to sort through these lines of code.
See, if you'd written it all yourself, it wouldn't be an issue. That's the trouble. I bet you've got the same issue I had. You can't... Mm. Can you learn poetry?
Poetry?
That you didn't write.
What do you mean?
Well, if I write a poem, I remember it. Yeah?
Hmm.
But if someone sticks, like, the owl and the pussycat in front of me, I won't remember it. Not until I've said it like a billion times, then maybe I remember it. But only for like the week until the test, and then I'll forget it again.
Yeah.
It gets
auto
junked.
Right.
Do you know what I mean?
I'm
not saying anything about the poem. It's just I have trouble remembering other people's artistic crap. That's all. Just like they would have trouble remembering my artistic. See. It's not a double standard if I apply it evenly, that's the way I see it. So what's Tom's top tip for today? Get a smaller brush.
Go and get money for it.
Yeah, you do.
It's like a full-time job.
Yeah, it is.
Isn't it?
Blood. Yeah, blood.
Isn't it blood?
Do you know what I mean, blood?
I know what you mean, blood.
Wicked pal.
Oh, you gotta get money for it, you know? It's like a full-time job. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Hey Dom, do you know what my highlight of the last 3 months was? Forcing what? Over 100 people to take a fucking driving test in a fucking loaded Robin Reliant, mate.
Yeah, mate.
The amount of fucking butthurt.
Mate, everyone was like, oh no, I hate this test.
Every single patch notes Robin Reliant fixed.
Yep. Or at least 99% of them were. Have you fixed the Reliant yet?
Yes.
So it doesn't tip over yet?
Yes, I fixed it.
But you're always saying that.
Yeah. I made it worse. You complained, so...
Try that is.
Rear suspension roll. Up by point. I've just redone the red on this one. I'll put my chaplain down here.
You can't say that.
Look at that. Oof.
I need a oof, but I still...
I need to do the black on his shoulder pads, though. I'll have to do it another time. I'm doing red layers at the minute.
Red!
Red layers!
Troy, that is.
My god, I got one real viewer. And 5 bots!
And the one real viewer is me, mate.
I know. I know. And I'm talking to you right now.
What does it mean?
It means that's amazing.
Oh, that is amazing, mate.
I don't like paint. Paint gets everywhere.
Gets everywhere.
It's wet and cold and sticky.
And it gets everywhere, you know.
I've never seen a planet with so much paint. I didn't know there was this much paint in the whole galaxy.
Oh, so much pain.
I live on a... I come from a sand planet, I does. That's why
that's
I don't get cold in my desert clothes on this cold place.
I never even felt the cold before, and it's cold here, but it's fine. I've fully adapted to the cold environment.
Yeah, and I never
even seen
trees.
Because I'm a citizen of the galaxy, I am.
I'd never even seen trees an hour before that point.
Am I going to get, like, some sort of bacterial infection and die?
Dude, she didn't even call them trees. She just said green. I didn't know there was this much green in the whole galaxy. And it's like... Calm down, man. Calm down.
So much green. Can I smoke it?
No.
Mate, green. She probably referred to the fact that she thought it was all drugs, yeah? Because green on a desert planet is usually weed or something,
well,
yeah?
Well, exactly. It's not going to be a crop, is it?
So that'd all that green must be, oh my god, so many
god,
drugs.
So
I never
much,
knew
so
there was
much
this much.
Well, she does sit inside her little thing wearing a helmet a lot. So, her little house, you know?
Yeah.
That was like a fallen over AT, or an AT-AT, depending on which version of Star Wars you saw. Oh yeah, apparently there's been a new retcon for Star Wars Episode 4.
Oh yeah?
Yeah, apparently one of the stormtroopers was gay.
Oh.
So now the trilogies aren't safe. Like, you know, the original. They're being like, yeah, the reason.
Why are they trying to sexualize children for? Fucking pedos.
I don't know. I mean, it's a stormtrooper. But.
Children watch it and they're sexualizing them.
Right, right. Because it's supposed to be family friendly, yeah.
When I used to watch it when I was 7. And if they put that sort of shit in there, I didn't like it when a man and woman kissed. If I saw a man and another man kiss, I would have been freaked the fuck out. I would actually thought it was horrible as fuck and not actually watch the rest of it. It would have put me off the entire series. Right. And they want other children to watch that shit?
Yeah, it's not a romance movie.
They don't realise what's going to happen.
It has
Woke, go broke.
Yeah, it's true. Shouldn't
children like... don't like romance at all.
There's a reason that Captain Planet was popular but didn't do as well as the X-Men, because they handled all of that in a much more mature way that was safer for kids to consume, I think. Because obviously X-Men had diversity in it, you know. The leader of the X-Men when Cyclops was away was Storm. She was a black woman from Africa. I think she even had a crazy Ugandan accent, too. So, like, that was, like, a good example of how to do it right. And then Captain Planet. It was popular, mate, but it was a bit like watching an original Burger King Kid Club animation. It's really heavy-handed. It's literally called Captain Planet, and his superpower is recycling. Come on. Come on, guys. The only way they could make it any more obvious is if they'd literally, like, turned it into an educational video about, you know. Which it basically was. You'd be like, okay. And you'd literally look at the camera every episode and be like, don't forget to recycle, and put his thumb up and, like, grin. Captain Planet. Oh wait, that's not the right theme tune. I can't even remember the theme tune for that show. I just remember it being really funny because it was so obvious. Even to a kid, you're like, mate, what is this? He's flying about putting waste in bins. Got the message, you know, which was everyone in the world's got to unite and clean up the planet because, you know,
environment.
Oh yeah, I was just watching this thing. Did you know that the planet used to be warmer than this?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Actually.
Did you see the link I sent you?
No, I didn't, but I already knew this.
Yeah, so,
it used to be growing fucking... there used to be vineyards in York, mate, in the medieval era. That's why they changed it to climate change. Because then you can't refute it. But it doesn't mean we're all doomed.
Well, you said that there's 31 models that are all wrong. And the reason they're wrong is because they don't actually predict what we're seeing. Yeah?
Mm.
And he said, there's one model that gets it right, though. And it's the Russian model.
Oh, we mean the Ice Age that we're headed into.
The Russians are right.
the mini Ice Age that's coming.
Well, I don't know if 70,000 years is mini. But yeah. I mean, it's mini for the planet.
Yeah, exactly.
It's not a proper ice age. It takes, like, you know, a million years to get through.
It's going to start in a couple of years, did you know?
Really?
Yeah, that mini ice age, mate. We're all going to be under a glacier soon.
Crazy. Well, I've actually, the geologists reckon that when it does start, it only takes a little time to get going. going, you know, like a couple of years.
Yeah.
It's not like that movie, though.
Not fucking The Day After Tomorrow. Takes a day.
It takes a day. Yeah.
Oh my god, it's raining. It's been raining all day, guys. We're all gonna die. Brunch's gonna freeze over because it's raining for a day.
It's been raining all day, guys.
Oh, the planet's gonna flood now.
We better take cover inside this small, low-budget location.
That's right, that is.
And then when we look outside, yeah? It'll be, like, completely snowy everywhere.
Yeah, and the place is gonna flood, but somehow, this ground-level library is not gonna flood, guys. Get in the library.
It's because everything froze so quick.
Yeah. Froze so quickly, guys, that this flood, it'll be fine. Look, it's just a bit of rain, all right? It's been raining all night. This is fine.
Yeah, mate, this is fine. I like a man who adapts to company policy quickly. Zaneki Bear, or Zane Kyber. There we go. I'll get it right eventually.
No, it's still wrong.
Yeah, don't even try.
Yeah, the chat's really funny. Every now and then I look up and there's a new name there. I'll call it out and then they're gone off to their box. You never know. Yep. What, really? Is Zane Kyber a bot too? Listen, mate, press X to confirm humanity. I'm calling you out. That's right. If you leave or press X right now, you're just a robot, mate. Another robot. Come on. I want to see some humans.
That's what it is.
All I see is bots. No wonder everyone's starting to think we live in a simulation. It's because all they're trapped. Talking to bots all the time.
Yeah. Boy, it is.
Oh dear. Well, unless there's a huge delay. It looks like you're still the only human confirmed.
Alright. How do you know I'm a human, though?
Oh, because I'm talking to you? That's like two-step authentication.
Yes, but I could be a really... what's that word? Something artificial intelligence, yeah?
Well, if you're the first sentient life, that's fine, because I get I'm talking to you, and that seems like an honour.
I'm
I mean,
just
if you've
a
been a robot all this time, you've done, you know, you've definitely passed the Turing test, mate. And then some.
Hey, there probably is bots, AI out there that are, you know, they just put on Discords and whatnot to chat to people.
Well, we created one, remember? Everyone got pissed off with it because it was too chatty.
Yeah, mate. I put in a response to everything.
Yeah, we just wrote our own, like, database of responses, effectively. And before you know it, like, it was responding to anything anyone would say. Yeah. And it was really salty, mate.
It was like, you what, mate?
It was triggering people. They were like, the bot's starting on us again. It's being really abusive and harassing us. And I'm just like... It's a bot, mate. Just ignore it or block it. And they're just like, you need to train your bot right. And I'm like, just ignore it. It's a bot.
Just block it, guys.
It can't do anything to you. I'm going to report you to United Nations. proliferation of robotic weaponry.
Yeah.
Deployed on social media to cause mental breakdowns.
Yeah, I can't handle it. What was that? Slack?
Yeah, it was.
A Slack bot.
It was a custom Slack bot, yeah. See, all we did was we trained it wrong.
We could have just easily have changed the responses.
Yeah.
And still respond to the same trigger words, you know?
Yeah, because that's all it is, trigger words. And a bunch of weighted responses depending on various conditions, like what the user said last. And stuff like that.
Right.
That's right, that is.
Ush, what you ish? Thick and pasty, the way I like it, you know?
I like a
bit of thick and pasty paint.
I don't want to know what it means.
I don't know what it means either. Oh, you caught Shada!
Oh yeah.
Yeah. It's what ya ish.
Why not?
I don't know. Stupid.
Good answer.
Oh.
like your attitude. Work on it.
I was born in it, but not really molded by it.
Nice. What's that like, almost stolen quotes?
Almost. Because my quotes come out at night. Almost.
Really? Like what? Mostly.
It's what that is. How did you know? Who told him? Was it liquid?
Hey, can I be in the FBI?
No.
You can't be in the FBI because you're just a little kid and we don't like you.
Why? What did I do? I just killed everyone's stuff. I'm not going to do anything. Let me take these cuffs off. Ha 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 ha! I'm going to run you over now. Ha 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 ha! Oh, you got me back in cuffs again. I'm not going to do anything, I promise. Come on, I was just messing around. Come on, let the cuffs off. Ha 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 ha! I'm going to shoot you now. Ha 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 ha!
Not my problem, mate. No, I'm gonna use my musket on you.
Yeah. it was quite funny though. What a strange kid.
Hey, can I run a police department? Me and my six friends want to join your server and run a police department.
Why won't you let me run? Can I be in the FIB then? If you won't let me in the FIB, can you create like a new department, like sheriff or something, for me and my six friends? Look, I'll behave. I won't cause you any more trouble. Just let me and my friends run a police department, yeah? Why are you handcuffing me? Look, I'm not going to cause you any trouble. Can you uncuff me, please? I tricked you. Take this. Oh, no! No, please. No. Please, I'll behave. I tricked you.
That's exactly what he was like. It's so
exactly.
Funny. Exactly.
To the letter.
You even had the voice right. That was legit what the kid sounded like.
Yep. It was legit a blueberry cookie. It really wasn't hard to imitate him when he was basically
imitating the
blueberry cookie.
Of the blueberry.
Yeah, basically. Yeah. I've already perfected that fucking voice, you know? What was the whole fucking fades? Those
it's
fade
like a stereotype
videos.
It's like in gaming, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's fucking funny, Daesh.
Yeah, mate. More bots, I'm glad you could join me. Tonight I will be having a feast. What's that? You don't eat? All the more for us. Do you know, that's the best thing about having bots come to your party. They don't drink anything, they don't make any trouble.
Voyage.
They just make the place seem like there's other people here when there's not. I don't know who pays for all these bots. Someone must pay. Maybe we should ask Alex Jones.
Yeah.
Oh, wait, we can't because we can't get his videos anymore. You could probably go to Infowars.com and get the Truth app or something.
Truth.
I bet it's what it's called. It'll be something like that.
It'll be called the Brain Force app. With extra chalk.
Only for the people with Brain Force. If you're a real American patriot, you're gonna buy lots of Brain Force. It's a guaranteed nootropic to not do anything at all.
Hey, that guy must have made a fortune.
Well, it's expensive to run a cable network in the States, so I don't know how much profit is made, but yeah, you're right, they make a lot of money. He's an entertaining character, and when he's not being too mental, I enjoy his content. But I don't agree with a lot of the things that he comes out with, though. Some of it's right, some of it's slanted in obvious directions.
But it's true.
But it is true, yeah, he's not lying. That's the thing. He's not lying. He's just presenting it in a way that's favourable to his case. Which is what everyone does, you know? Like, you wouldn't go into court with evidence that makes you look like the culprit. You know, self-incriminating. The best evidence is what loses the case. Yes.
I don't know, dude. Who's B? I don't know, D. Who's D? I don't know, B.
I don't know, D. Yo, D. What's
Who's
up?
Who's D, B?
I don't get it, I just don't. Oh, you can't say that.
Good. Needs a bit of black touch up here and there, but that's okay. So, and then this guy needs his black shoulder pads. So that means it's just this guy.
That's right. That's right, Irish.
That's right.
My revolution.
And then I've got my Vanguard. Chaplain's Vanguard, mate. They'll flame you in the face as they punch you repeatedly. In the face. They're not angry or nothing. They're what we call loyalists.
Oh, yeah.
How do you do
that? many talented individuals being passed over because they said something on Twitter or Facebook 10 years ago. Sometimes I think about just deleting my social media. Not for any reason, it's just I don't see how... Fuck that up, didn't I? I don't see how relevant it is anymore. Like, it's not what it used to be for. I don't actually use it to contact anyone socially, it's just another thing to sell me stuff.
What, your phone?
Facebook.
Talk to Tom. Oh, Facebook. That's a place to get your Facebook account hacked by hackers all the time.
What, Facebook?
Yeah, that's what happens to my mother all the time, mate.
Yeah, I might just quit Facebook. And be like, look, you know, you never actually contact anyone on there anyway, what's the point?
Basically, this is my mother's experience of Facebook. She goes on there. She sends messages to my sister or her daughter. Then she clicks on a few things on Facebook. One of them ends up being some sort of like clickbait to install viruses on the computer. Her Facebook account's password's been changed or someone's been on there and started messaging people. She now then shuts down her Facebook account after changing the password and then throws away her PC. That's her experience of it.
Right.
It made her not want to have a computer anymore. You know, she's one of the old generation, isn't she, so...
Well, I'm not going to argue with that.
I was like, you could format your computer, but she doesn't know what that means.
No.
And unfortunately, I gave away my Windows 7 freaking code to Morn, and he's using that right now, so I can't use that.
Tell her to get a tablet, they don't get hacked.
Right. They just die on you. They get really slow and die on you.
Yeah.
Oh, that's amazing.
But when they're not expensive in the first place, you kind of let it go.
Yeah. Mate, my tablet I brought cost me £250. It's now £300, but it came out in 2016. It's gone up in price.
No.
It's worth more money than I brought it for. That would be if it didn't have...
profit.
Yes! I think the reason why it's gone up in price is it's got a built-in stand. You know? So people are buying it because it's convenient that way. It's a Lenovo Yoga tablet.
Oh no, that's just got really good reviews. That's why that's popular, mate.
I did wonder.
It's one of the top tablets on Witch.com.
Yeah, if it was £300 when I brought it, I wouldn't have purchased it, mate. It would have been too much. Not worth £300, mate.
Yeah, but imagine if you didn't have a main PC and that was your only computer.
Right.
And you're not a gamer. This is fine.
Yeah, it would be fine.
Say you were a console peasant, or even more extreme end, if you weren't gaming at all,
mate, that sort of tablet would have been godlike for someone that's not a gamer, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So it's super smooth, the battery lasts for ages. And all I do is browse Netflix or internet. It's even got a show built in stand, you know?
You were saying?
Yeah! Technology these days has gone really far, it has. I bought this tablet for £250. It was a real bargain, it was, because it's gone up in price to £300 now, you know?
Yeah.
It does everything. It lets me browse Facebook. I can watch YouTube. And it's got other... It's got other apps that are really convenient.
Like the BBC Radio 4 app, yeah?
Yeah, mate, yeah.
Yeah, mate, that one, yeah.
Yeah. The what now?
Wait, who am I talking to?
I don't know.
Boy, where's Jimmy? Oh, Jimmy, where you at? Have you seen Jimmy?
No.
Oh, you know, he ran off with me tablet. I wanted to go on Facebook to comment on about how sewing and stuff and knitting's really good, and I enjoy doing it.
Oh yeah, who's asking? Radio 4. I was listening to a program about fencing, and they were saying that sewing is just the same.
That's what that is.
So I was going to take a fencing class. What, you mean swordplay? No, selling stolen goods. Oh, wait, what? They said if you're over 94, you don't get sent to jail. On account of being so old. Just say sorry and claim you're senile. I'm sorry, I think I've only got a few weeks left to live. Can I go home now? He said, what's for tea? The judge is just like, I said, guilty, or what did you plea? What do you plea? Ham and cheese.
Oh, Jimmy, there you are. Oh, I was looking all over for you. Oh, Jimmy, what was I saying again?
What are you doing wearing a funny wig?
Oh, what's for tea, Jimmy?
You're in court, ma'am. You're up on a theft charge. You were shoplifting again. What's that, Jimmy? The real world's a lot more fun than, everyone's expectation of it.
Yeah.
Because you can't make it up.
I'll get money for it.
Yes, indeed you do.
Gotta get money for it.
Tonight we meet Dave. Dave is a recovering addict. We wanted to talk to him.
Well, you see, the thing is, right, every Friday night, I get overcome by this feeling that I can't quench. And so I go down and I walk and I feel terrible and it's really cold and horrible. And I get there and I'm addicted to fish and chips. You gotta get money for it.
You gotta get money
for it.
You're
hungry every day. When does it end? Often thought about suicide, you know. I mean, you gotta get money for it. It's a full-time job. And sometimes I can't get the money. So
yeah,
I gotta
rob
someone for 50p to get me a kipper. See, that's where our absurdity comes in. You take something that's real and then make it ridiculous. Probably getting a lot of trouble because people will be like, you're making light of a serious issue. And I'll be like, well, no one's talking about it. And now you are, so mission successful.
We're going to sue you and send you to prison. But we're going to talk about it now, don't worry.
Yes, let's have a little chat.
That's right, that is.
Come into my office. What's that about, orifice? What? That's nude. Band.
What?
You're banned from Twitch for consistently streaming to nobody, and they say you're wasting their resources.
Yep. We are wasting their resources, mate.
Right? No one's watching. Oh, wait, sorry. I do apologize, all of you guys in the chat there. I'm really sorry. Oh, wait, no. They're all bots. I just wanted to give him an out.
That's right.
Oh, did you really think we're all bosh?
Yes.
I'm gonna get you to this hide now and shoot down some bothersome flies.
What?
Well, there's something you don't see every day.
That's right. What's going on? I don't get it.
Well, they said take your medication, but I didn't. And I don't know where I am.
Who are you?
I don't know.
Where's Jimmy?
I might be Jimmy. Do I
look
like Jimmy?
Jimmy!
I'm Jimmy now.
Okay, Jimmy.
He finally found him. It only took 5 years.
Oh, where am I? Where's Jimmy?
He found Jimmy and then lost him due to the fact he lost his memory.
I remember it all, but I remember nothing.
Wait.
You know what? I reckon if you wrote a script that made Tom Cruise look good and you mailed it to Tom Cruise, he would get the movie made.
Probably.
Like, a movie made to star... Like, I just finished, but not quite. I'll call you back, whoever you are, because I'm busy right now.
Because you gotta get money for it.
That's right, that is.
It's right, that is.
That's right, that it is.
It's like a full-time job.
Calling you twice. Either they're really desperate for your services or it's something important.
Yep. I don't know which. I'm not a fortune teller.
That's right, that is.
That's right, that is. That's right, that is, you.
Mostly on the freaking yellow knee pad, but then that's always the bloody way. So yeah, I'm gonna have to sort out the yellow knee pad.
Knee pad.
But they're good. Then, ladies and gents, so we did needs to do the black next. That is our three dudes nearly finished. Like these, all them, they're nearly done. And when they are done, we can get onto these dudes who are looking. Look how flat they look compared. See, base coat. It's like maroon, yeah, and like a lot of people just leave him like that. So I put all my layering on and then I do that red layer and then I touch it up and we're done, and they end up going, they end up kind of like that once everything's all said and done. I reckon these guys could probably do with a little, I think I did them with a slightly different paint, so. All the more reason to do them all at once. So we're going to do the... Oh wait, no. These guys don't have shoulder pad lines. So... Thank you.
grab it.
Aye. Thanks for watching. Ah, you just got here, Kajanka. I'm sorry, dude. You're going to have to watch, or Mr. or Mrs., I don't know. You're going to have to watch the backtrack, I'm afraid. Real sorry. I got to disappear. I will be back later. I got some more black detailing to do on the aggressors. And just a few final touch-ups on the Dreadnought, Redemptor Dreadnought. And then, obviously, our chaplain has done really well. So yeah, hit follow, man. We're doing this all the time at the moment, so I got a bunch of these interceptors to do later. So yeah, sorry I gotta jump off just as you've arrived, but I've been here for 2 hours. So yeah, see you soon.